Next session in dynamic programming. So today we are going to look into the two algorithms. So one is called as the Warshall's algorithm, the other one is called as the Floyd's algorithm. So now the Warshall algorithm, now the it is used for computing the transitive closure of a directed graph. So we are going to use Warshall's algorithm to compute the transitive closure of a given graph. And Floyd's algorithm, now it is used for finding all pair shortest path problem, right? So now we have seen Dijkstra's algorithm, now through which we are going to find single source shortest path, right? Now whereas the Floyd's algorithm, now it is used to find all pair shortest path problem. So now these are the two problems now today now we are going to discuss in this session. So both of these problems, again, it comes under our dynamic programming. So now let us start with our Warshall's algorithm. So now what is this algorithm it is used for? Now this algorithm is used for computing the transitive closure of a directed graph, right? So now we are given a directed graph, and this algorithm is used to find the transitive closure. So now we'll look into the definition of a transitive closure. Now what is the definition, or how we are going to define a transitive closure? So a transitive closure of a directed graph, right? A transitive closure of a directed graph with n vertices, now can be defined as n cross n Boolean matrix, T equal to small t of ij. Now you know that what is the meaning of a Boolean matrix, right? Boolean matrix means it is a matrix which constitutes only 0 and 1. Now the matrix has got only 0 and 1. So a transitive closure of a directed graph with n vertices, we are given a directed graph which has n vertices. Now transitive closure can be defined as a n cross n Boolean matrix, in which the elements in the ith row, and jth column is 1, right? So ith row and jth column in that matrix, it is 1 if there exists a non-trivial directed path. What you are going to tell? If there exists a non-trivial directed path. So that is directed path of positive length. So whenever we have got a directed path of positive length from ith row to jth column in our matrix T, we represent it as 1, otherwise we mark it as 0, right? Now this is how we define a transitive closure of a given graph. Now let us try to look here. Now we are given a graph, right? So now this is a directed graph. Now how many vertices are there? 4 vertices are there, named as A, B, C and D. Now we have already defined something called as adjacent matrix. So you know that whenever we are taking a graph, we can convert or we can represent the graph in terms of adjacent matrix. Now let us try to write the adjacent matrix for this given graph. Now this is our given graph, now which has got A, B, C, D, and A, B, C, D. These are the 4 vertices. Now first we will write the adjacent matrix, okay? Now how do you define an adjacent matrix? Now it is also a Boolean matrix only. Now how do it is defined? If there exists an edge from ith vertex to jth vertex, we represent it as 1, else 0 in our adjacent matrix. Okay, so now let us take this. Now from vertex A now to B, is there any edge? Yes, there is a directed edge from A to B. So from, we start from here, from A to A. So from A to A you don't have any edge, so we will write it as 0. We will mark it as 0. Now from A to B, so from A to B there is a directed edge, so we represent it as 1. And from A to C, so from A to C you don't have any edge, so again we write as 0. And from A to vertex D, from A to D there is a directed edge, so we will write it as 1. Clear? So now this is the first row. For we'll go to the second row. How do we write? B to A, right? From B to A. From B to A, do we have an edge? No. So we mark it as 0. And from B to B also 0. Now what about from B to C? So from B to C you have an edge, so we write it as 1. And from B to D, there is an edge. From B to E, sorry, from B to D, you don't have an edge. An edge is there, but the direction is reversed. So from B to D, we mark as 0. Now we'll come from C. We'll start scanning from vertex C. So from C to A, you don't have any edge, so we write as 0. From C to B, no edge. From C to C, obviously you don't have an edge from that same vertex to the other vertex. From C to D, you have an edge, so we mark as 1. Now the last vertex D. From D, how many vertices are connected? Right? So now from D to A, there is no edge, so we'll write as 0. From D to B, yes, you have an edge, we'll write as 1. See, from D to B, there is a directed edge, so D to B, 1. And D to C, you don't have any edge, so we'll mark as 0. And from D to D, also 0. So now this is the adjacent matrix, right? Now we have to get the transitive closure of this matrix. Now the transitive closure of the matrix is called as T. Now what we have defined, look into our definition of transitive closure. It says that if there exists a path, non-trivial directed path from ith row to jth column. Right? So now we'll start. So again we'll write one matrix. Right? This is transitive closure. So now from A to A. From A to A, do you have any edge? So we'll represent it with 0. From A to B, yes, we have an edge. Now here also we are going to write it as 1. From A to C. Now you can see in adjacent matrix, from A to C, 0. That means from A to C, you don't have direct edge. But if you observe properly, we can go from A to B and B to C. Right? So from A to C, we can go via B. There is a direction from A to B and B to C. So hence, from A to C, we write 1 here. Whereas in adjacent matrix, it was 0. You can see here. In adjacent matrix, it was 0. But here, you get 1. And from A to D, yes, obviously we have an edge. So write it as 1. Clear? So next we'll go to the, so now we'll start from vertex B, so second row. So now you see from B to A, do you have an edge? Direct edge we don't have from B to A, but C, can you go to vertex A via B, sorry, from B, so by any ways, is there any directed path? So from B, there is only one path it takes us to C. From C, it takes us to D. And from D, it takes back to B, right? But we cannot come to A. So from B to A, we write 0. There is no path for us. Now from B to B. So now, is there any path? So from B to B in adjacent matrix, we are writing 0. But now see here, from B, you can go to C. From C to D and D to back to B. So B to B, there is a path. What about from B to C? There is a path, right? There is directed edge itself. And from B to D, so you can go B to C, C to D. So here also 1 will come. Clear? I think it is now clear for us how we are getting the transitive closure. So now from vertex C. Now from C to C. Can you come to C? So from C, you can go to D. From here to B. And you can come to C, right? So now what we are saying, so from C to B, so you have an edge. So from C to D you can go, and from D to B you can try to go. So from C to B also 1, from C to C also 1, right? From C to C also 1, because from C to D, D to B, B to C, you can come back to C. So here also 1, and from C to D you have an edge, 1, Now what about from vertex D? From D, can you come back to D by any, from D to A first. From D, is there any ways you can reach A? Now let us see. From D, you can go to B. From here, direction takes us to C. And from C, it takes back to D. You cannot reach A. So from D to A, 0. And from D to B, there is a path. From D to C, also path. You can see it clearly. And from D to D, also path exists. Now this, we call it as a transitive closure of a given directed graph. Right? So it can be a directed graph or it can be an undirected graph also. We can try to find the transitive closure. So this is the adjacent matrix and this is the transitive closure. Now how are we going to do this? Right? So manually it is very easy for us, or it is very simple. We have written this particular thing. But manually how we are going to, or algorithmically how we are going to design this particular algorithm. Now you can see that now we can obtain the transitive closure by transferring the given directed graph either, or by traversing the graph either by DFS or DFS. So we can transfer, we can traverse this graph either by a depth first search or by a breadth first search. So now by any means, now you can try to find the transitive closure. But if you are using either the DFS or BFS, now what it says, from one vertex you have to visit all the vertices, right? If you are able, then you can get it. But if you are trying to do it, if you have got n vertices, so then the time required is very, very large for us. The time required is very large for us. So hence, now we are going to come up with an algorithm, now which is called as the Warsh's algorithm. So if your graph has got n vertices, now it needs n traversal if you are using either the depth first search or the breadth first search. So to overcome that, we are going to use an algorithm called as the Warsh's algorithm. So you have to remember, so why we are using this Warsh's algorithm? To find the transitive closure of a given graph. Now in the examination, if they ask you, you find the transitive closure of the graph, that means you have to use Warsh's algorithm. Now how do we calculate by using Warsh's algorithm? Now here, now we construct the transitive closure of a graph with n vertices through a series of n cross n Boolean matrix. Now what it says, now you are going to create one by one, it is a series of matrices, n by n Boolean matrix. So the first matrix we are going to start with is denoted as R superscript 0. So from 0. So then R1, R2, Rk, etc. up to Rn. So this is how we are going to find our whenever finding the matrices, that is n by n Boolean matrix is been constructed. Now we have to see how we are going to construct these series of matrices, right? So now each of these matrices will give some information on your diagraph. So when you start with this matrix R of 0, it gives some information. R of 1, it gives some information. Seriously, you keep on doing, and the last matrix R of n, it actually gives you the transitive closure of the given graph. Now let us see the method, how we are doing. Now first we start with R of 0. Now what is our R of 0? The first matrix is nothing but the adjacent matrix of the graph. We are going to start with the adjacent matrix of the graph. So we have seen how we are going to write a adjacent matrix. Just now we have seen. So first, given, take the graph, write the adjacent matrix of the graph. Clear the second step. Now, if an element Rij is 1, right? If already in our matrix, if an entry is 1 for ith row, from ith vertex to jth vertex, if 1 is there in R of k minus 1, that means in your previous matrix, then it remains 1 in the current matrix also, right? Suppose say that now R of 0, R of 1, R of 2, etc. you are doing. Now you are to come an intermediate step. Now you are supposed to write for R of k. How are you going to construct this matrix R of k? So before you are going to construct this R of k, previous is k minus 1. You have already one matrix will be there. Now in that matrix R of k minus 1, for ith row to jth column, now if you have already one, that means if there is an edge or a path from this vertex I to vertex j, it will be 1. So you retain same thing. So in this matrix also, if in previous matrix if 1 is there, in this new matrix R of k also you are going to represent 1 only, right? Next step, if an element I to j is 0, so if you have got 0 in your previous matrix, now it can be changed to 1, it can be, there is no rule that every time it will be 1 only, so it can be changed to 1 if in R of k, if and only if from I to k, right? So you are going with one vertex now. From the ith vertex, from I to k and from k to j, if there is a path, if there is a path, that means in from I to k, if you have got 1 and from k to j also 1 is there, then in both the places 1 is there, means now R of ij will be equal to 1, right? So this is how we are going to do. So let us look into this diagram so it will be more clear for us. Now we want to construct this matrix R of k. To write this, previously we have filled all this matrix, which is that R of k minus 1, right? Now if you look into R of k minus 1, now say that you are supposed to write design R of k, that means you are at this particular row, so kth row and kth column, you observe these two, kth row and kth column. So now from k to j, from k to j if you have got 1, right, from k to j you have got 1, and from I to k you have got 1, from I to k, right, if it is equal to k to j, R of k to j, if both are 1, so in this place, that means in ij, for k, right, for rk, now in this place, in this I and j place, here 0 was there in previous matrix, but in new matrix 1 will come. Why 1 we are writing here? Because, so kj is 1 and ik is 1. That indicates that to go from ith vertex to jth vertex, you are going or we are moving via vertex k. Right, from I to k you go and from k to j you go. So then it is nothing but you are going from I to j. So here in this matrix you are going to mark it as 1. So this is how the Warshall's algorithm is being used to find the transitive closure. Now let us take an example and we will see this. Now we will consider this given graph. Now for this particular graph, now you are going to write the adjacent matrix. Right, now here we have written, so initially here now we have written the adjacent matrix for this graph. Now this will be our first initial matrix R of 0. Now R of 0 is what? Now this is our adjacent matrix. Now we will start with that particular adjacent matrix R of 0. So that will be your first step, right? So now what will be your R of 0? So you are going to consider R of 0 as your adjacent matrix. Now this is our adjacent matrix. Now we have written, so this is called as R of 0. Now R of 0 is equal to what? So how do we get? This is the adjacent matrix of our given graph. So next step you are going to construct R of 1, right? So you write A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D. Now how we are going to construct? Now to construct R of 1, to construct this matrix, what you do is that circle first row and first column, right? So circle like this, first row and first column. So now in R of 1, right, this is our R of 1 already we got. Now we will try to do it once again. So now R of 1, so now whichever rows and column you have circled, you write those values in that as it is. that means, so here, so 0, right? So 0, 1, 0, 1. So we'll write as it is. So 0, 1 and 0, 1. That is this row. This column also same values. Now what is the values are there in the first column? 0, 0, 0, 0. All are 0. So we will write this as 0, 0, 0 and 0. Right? So we are constructing now R of 1. So first you circle first row, first column. Write whatever values are them as it is. Clear? So now we have to enter here, BB. Right? You have to get a value in this position. That is this position. Now you observe, now this element, you compare this element and this element. So this is 0, this is 1. Right? Both are different. If both are 1, then only this becomes 1. But here one is 0, one is, other one is, value is 1. Both are different. So we will write 0 as it is. No changes. Right? The next one, BC. What is there in the previous matrix BC, B and C, 1 is there. So if 1 is there, you retain as it is in your R of 1. Don't do any changes. If 1 is there, just copy it as it is. Next you have got 0. Now you compare here. So the here, right? Here 0 is there. You check this value inside the circle. Here we have got 0. Here, in this way, 1 is there. Both are different, so it will be 0. It will be 0 1. Correct? So next, here CB. So C and B. This value. So previous, what value you are having in R of 0? 0 is there. So 0 is there means in R of 1, it can be 0 or it can be 1. Right? You have to check. Now, how you are going to check here? So you look into this particular row here. So here, value is 0. Right? This column value is 0. And in this row, here 1 is there. So this is 0 and 1. Both are different. So the value will be 0 as it is. Right? So next CC. So now look into this one. Now we are looking this value. So here 0. Here 0 obviously. So this also 0. Both should be 1. Then only 1 will come here. Right? Now what about this? 1. 1 is there, obviously. If you have got 1, write as it is. Don't do any changes. Now, last row. Clear? So now, D, B. This value we need. D and B. So now, D, B. You see what value you are having? 1. So if 1 you are having, retain 1 as it is. Next one. You have 0 here. Now look here. Here 0 is there. Here also 0 is there, so 0 only we are going to take. Now what about the last one? Here 0, here 1, both are different, so write 0. Now this you have constructed R1, if next matrix R1, this is what we have written here. So now if you look here in this matrix, now, so there is no change. Right? So from this matrix to this matrix, now you can see nowhere you got any change. Now we will construct R of 2. Right? Now to construct R of, now you got this one. Now to construct R of 2, what you have to do? You circle the second row like this and second column. Right? So you circle second row and second column. So now after circling the second row and second column, you have to construct R of 2. Write down again A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D. Now whichever rows and column you have circled, write those values in this R of 2 as it is. Right? So now the circled, see the circled row here is 0, 0, 1, 0. So here we'll write as it is value 0, 0. 0, this is 0, and here is 1 and 0, correct? And row you have completed. Now what about this column? So 1, 0, 0, 1. So you will write the same values here, 1, 0, 0, and 1. Clear? So now I think it is clear. So 1, 0, 0, 1. So whatever the rows and column you have circled, those values you write as it is. So now you have to fill all the remaining entries in our matrix R of 2. Right? Now this one, here you have to fill. Now look here. This one you have to fill, right? This is same now. Right? This matrix and this matrix is same. So we have written it. So now you want to fill here AA. Now to fill that AA, now you are going to, you want to fill here. Here 0 is there. In our new matrix R of 2, what value you have to write here? Now what you are going to do? Compare this. This value is 0, this value is 1. This is 0, 1. So both are different. So this value will be 0 only. So here we will write 0. So next. AC here, this entry we need, that is this entry. Now you have to look into this entry. So now to look this entry, now you are going to compare this. See, always you are going to compare the entries present in our circle, so which we have circled rows and column, right? So now this entry you want to compare. Now the corresponding value here in this circled row is 1. Right, and corresponding to this in this particular column, circled column here is 1. Now you see here also 1, here also 1. So in this place you are going to write 1 here. Is it clear now? So now here is 1, here is 1. So we are going to write 1 here. We are going to replace this 0 with 1. So what it says is that when you are going to write, so in your matrix R2, that is in R2, so 1, 3, the first row, third column, right? The first row and third column, you are making it as 1. So why you make it as 1? Because it indicates that from A to B, there is an edge, and from B to C, there is an edge. So this 1 indicates there is an edge, right? From A to B there is an edge, and from B to C there is an edge. A to B, B to C. That means from A to C you have an edge, but 0 was there, but we are going to write it as 1 here. That's how we are going to construct a transitive closure. Clear? Now the last entry here, AD. So we are going to look for AD. In AD already 1 is there, so need not worry, write 1 as it is. Now we have to fill for CA, which is one CA. That means this, you have to observe this entry now. Now to observe this entry, now which all the values you are going to compare? So row wise inside your circled, so which is this entry here? 0. Now here is 0. Both are 0, so this value will be 0. Right, next CC. This value you are going to check. Clear? So now if you want to check this value, here 1 is there, here 0 is there. Both are different. So this also will be, value will be 0. Next, the last one, the third row, CD. CD. So what is there in our previous matrix? 1 is there. Right? So CD, 1 is there means what? No need of doing any changes, take 1 as it is. So now we'll go to the last row. So now DA, so this one is 0, right? Now since it is 0, you have to check it. If it is 1, no need to check, write as it is. So 0 is there, so here 0 is there, here 1 is there. So 0 and 1 are different, so we will write mark 0. Now what about D and C? DC here. Now in this position also you have got 0. So now you have to compare. Now corresponding here what you are having? 1. And here 1 is there. So that means, so now here also 1, here also 1. So obviously this value entry will become 1. That entry will become 1. Now the last value, this one. Right? You have 0, you check here 1 and here 0, both are different, so you are going to write 0. Clear? So now we have constructed the matrix R2, right? This will be 0. So we constructed R2. So this is what we have constructed. Is it clear now? So now from R1 to R2, so what changes we got in R2? First row, third column. So the first row, third column, we got 1, right? Here 0 was there, here we got 1. And fourth row, third column, 4, 3. So that is fourth row, third column. Here 1, here 0 was there, now we got 1. These were the two new changes are added, new one you are having. Right? So now why we got, say for it, let us one second try to understand. First row, third column, right? First row, third column. So that is here we have written 1 here. So here it was 0. Why? Because from A to B you have 1. Right? From A to B you are having 1. That is R, right? R from A comma B. Or A comma B is what? First row. This is second column. So you can also write it as R, first row, right? Second column, R1 comma 2. Now what is R1 comma 2? Which is equal to 1. And what about R, second row, 2 comma 3? R, 2 comma 3. Now if you consider R2, 3, what value you are having? R2, 3 is also 1. Right? Now see, R1, 2 is 1. R2, 3 is 1. So therefore R1, 3. So therefore what you can say? R1, 3 is equal to 1. So R1, 3. So this is 1 comma 3. So this R1 comma 3 will be equal to 1. Similarly, now for this also, right? Now this equation you can write here in the examination like this, you can do it. So now we have constructed R2. Now we have to construct R3. Now construct R3, what you have to do? So now you see here in R1, second row, second column you have circled. Now third row and third column. So now you circle your third row, right? Like this. Circle third row and third column. So once you have circled your third row and third column, now in R3 you write down the circled value as it is. So now this row you have circled. That is what value you are having? 0001. So under C, you write down the same values, 0, 0, 0, 1, right? So now this column, what value you are having? 1, 1, 0, 1 in the Cf column. So what is that value? 1, 1, 0, 1, right? Now after writing this, now in this matrix, in the remaining entries, wherever 1 is there, you write down that also. Clear? So now here 1 is there, right? In B, that is AB, 1 is there. You write here 1. AD, 1 is there. Here also you write 1. Now in B, 1 is there. Already 1 you have written here. And in this last column, DB, 1 is there. So in D and B, in this place, write 1. Any else 1 is there? No, all 1s you have returned. Right? All 1s you have returned. This is the circled row and this is the circled column. Now you have to fill the remaining values. Now you are going to fill the remaining values. So now, so you are going to start with this one. Right? Here you have to fill AA. Now what is the value AA you are having? 0. So since you have 0, now you observe this. So corresponding this value here, what you are having? 0. And in this row, 1 is there. Both are different. So what value you are going to write? Here you are going to write as 0. Now we will come to BA, this one. We are going to check this one. Right? Now corresponding here, what value? 0 is there. and in this row 1 is there, so both are different, so this value will be 0 as it is. Now you have to check this one. Wherever 0 is there, you keep on checking. Now this, so corresponding here 0, here 1, both are different, so this 0 will be as it is, so we mark it as 0. So now this 0, right? So here 1 and here 1. Now you can see here, so R of 2, 3, 1, and R of this is 3, 1. So you are going to write now. So what values you are having? You are checking this one, right? So when you are going to check this value here, so corresponding this 1 is there and here 1 is there. So that is why this entry will become 1. Right? What is this entry? This is 2, 4. So how you got this value as 1 here? Because R of 2, 3. So R of 2, 3, that is second row third column, is 1. Correct? R of second row third column, this value, this is 2, 3, right? So this is 1. And what about this R of 3, 4? R of 3, 4 is equal to 1. Right? So R of 2, 3 is equal to 1 and R of 3, 4 is equal to 1. Therefore R of what? 2, 4. This is what we are going to check. Second row, fourth column, right? This is 2, 4. So R of 2, 4 is equal to how much now? This becomes 1. Right? You can see here. So R of 2, 3 is 1, R of 3, 4 is 1. So now this 3, if you cancel, R of 2, 4 is equal to 1. So here we are going to get 1. Clear? So now you have to fill this value. So that means you have to check this 0. Here 0 is there, and you are going to check. Now here you see 0 and 1, both are different, so this value will be 0 as it is. What about the last one you are going to check? So now R of 3, 4 is equal to 1 and R of 4, 3 is equal to 1. So therefore both are 1, 1, therefore this value will be 1. So here you are going to write 1. I think it is now clear. So now we have constructed R3. So how many vertices are there? 4 vertices are there. So now we have to construct 4 matrix. Now we have to come for last matrix R4. Now to construct this matrix R4, go to your previous matrix. So now circle which row? Fourth row and fourth column. So you circle the fourth row and fourth column. Right? Now you see how we have done. So we started with the adjacent matrix, right? This was our given adjacent matrix was R0. So then we circled here first row, first column, in next matrix second row, second column, then third row, third column. Now you circle fourth row and fourth column. So now you are going to construct the last matrix here, R of 4. Now this R of 4 gives you the transitive closure. So what we have to do? So first, what I told, write down the values which you have circled. So this row you have circled, right? So we'll write down that value here. What are that values? 0, 1, 1, and 1. And this column you have circled, all are 1 here. So we'll write 1, 1, 1, and 1. Right? 4 ones. Now in this matrix, which all positions 1 is there, you enter it here. So here 1 is there at AB. So here we'll write 1, and AC also 1 is there, and in BC 1 you are having, right? Anywhere else 1 is there? No, all 1s you have written. So now for remaining all zeros, now you are going to inspect. Right? This is first one. We'll start with this zero. Right? Now here value zero is there. Here value one is there. So both are different. So this value will be zero. So now we'll check this one. Here zero, here one, both are different. So this also will be zero. Right? This zero is over now. This zero is over. You check all zeros, wherever zeros are there. Now again here zero is there. Now here one is there and here one is there. Right? Both are 1, 1. So this value should be 1. So once you write here 1, you write down like this. Right? You write down like this in your next step. Right? Now second row, all entries are over. Now you have to come for third row. This is over now. Still 3 zeros are left to check. So we'll start with this 0. So here 0, 1, both are different. So this value will be 0. So this is over. Now inspect this one. Corresponding down here 1 is there and here 1. In both places 1, 1 is there. So here at CB, what value you have to get? You get 1. Right? Now this is completed. Now we are left with last value, this 0. You check this. Corresponding here 1, here also 1. So obviously in this place, next matrix, you will get 1. Right? So now all entries are been completed. Now this is your final answer. What we can say, this R4 is the transitive closure of the given graph. Here, this is the transitive closure of the given graph. So you are given a graph, now you have to find the transitive closure of this. So in the examination, so how you start working, look your graph properly and first step write the adjacent matrix. Right? You have to go and write the adjacent matrix. And then you start constructing R of 1, R of 2, R of 3, R of 4. Let us look into the algorithm. How we are going to design this Warshall's algorithm. Now what is input for this Warshall's algorithm? Now it is a given graph, right? So we are given graph. So now what is the input? Adjacent matrix A. So you have to take your graph and give an adjacent matrix. Right? The first step what you are telling? You have to construct the adjacent matrix of the given graph A. So is a the input. Now what is the output? You get transitive closure of the directed graph. So what algorithm says? You start with the first step R of 0, first matrix. What is your first matrix? It is your adjacent matrix only. Now then, now we are going to process this matrix, right? So we need three for loops. So for k is equal to 1 to n, for I is equal to 1 to n, for j is equal to 1 to n. Now how do you get R of k, new matrix, R of k of ij, you are going to assign. Now in your previous matrix, that is k minus 1, if already 1 is there, I comma j means if you have already 1, you write 1 itself, or if you have 0, then you check this condition. What is that? From I to k, if you have 1, and from k to j also if you have 1, so here you write that 1 here. Right? This is what we have done manually. So finally you return R of n. So this will be your transitive closure. So now if you try to analyze this particular, since it is a very small algorithm, right? It is a very simple thing. 8 marks question it is. So it is a very simple and easy where you can get easily marks in your examination. Now the analysis, if you try to do it, it is very simple. Now the basic operation here is the based on R and condition, right? Here you have R and you are having and operations. So since it is only one, right? Any one you are going to do, you have three for loops. It is converted into summations and one of basic operation. And when you remove one by one summation, if you solve this, you are going to get n cube, right? By using the previous in first units, you have seen how you remove the first summation, inside summation, upper bound minus lower bound plus 1. Apply it, simplify it, then remove the second summation, then remove your third summation. When you remove, you get n cube. So you can say the time complexity of Warshall's algorithm is theta of n cube. Clear? So now when you are looking this, this is about our Warshall's algorithm. Now let us take an another example, and we'll try to see the example from the textbook, and we'll see how that is been solved. Yes. Now let us take another example. Now this is the example from the textbook, and we'll try to see how we are going to find the transitive closure. Right. So now this is a given directed graph. So now first step, what you are going to do is that now you try to construct a adjacent matrix. Now if you look here, so from A to B, from A to A, you don't have any edge, 0. From A to B, an edge is there, 1. From A to C, you don't have any edge, so we write 0. And from A to D, you don't have direct edge, 0. This is transitive, this is adjacent matrix you are going to write. Because the first step to solve for us is, you are going to construct a adjacent matrix, that is our matrix R of 0, right? So now let us take that particular graph, and what we try to do is, so now we are going to start with the adjacent matrix, right? This is our graph, and we are writing R of 0. So now how we are getting R of 0? So we write the adjacent matrix. So next is R of 1. To get R of 1, what you have to do? You circle the first row, right? Circle your first row and first column. So in R of 1, first what you are going to do? Now this entries you write as it is, right? So 0, 1, 0, 0. Then 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. And after entering the first row, first column as it is, wherever 1 is there, you write as it is. So here 1 is there, enter it. Here also 1 is there. Now remaining zeros, you have to scan or you have to verify. Now we'll start with this one. Now this is 0, right? Right? Now corresponding to here value 0 and here 1, both are different. So this 0 will be as it is. So you are going to get. Now what about this 0? Here 0 is there, here also 0, so now this 0 will be as it is. Next to this one, here 0, 1, both are different, so now CB, this 0 will be as it is. The next 0, 0, 0, so this will be 0 as it is. Here also 0, here also 0, here also we will get 0 as it is. Right? So next to this. Now you can see here 1 is there, here 1 is there. So both are same, 1, 1. So this entry in your next matrix, it should be 1. So now you can see it is given in bold letter. So here 0 was there. In our next matrix, you get 1. Here 1 already you have written. Now the last one is 0. 1 and 0 both are different. So you write 0 as it is. So you constructed R1. So next step, R of 2. So to construct R of 2, what you have to do? Circle second row and second column. Circle this row and this column. Right? So now this one you are going to check. Right? 0 is there. So if you check here, so here 0, 1, so no change. So here 0 only it will be there. Now what about this? Also 1 and 0, so it will be 0 only. Here 1 is there, 1 is there, so both place 1 is there. So now this value 0 in R1, in R2 it will become 1. Right? So now about this one, this 0 you have to check. Here is also 0, both place 0 is there, so you will get 0 as it is. Here also you will get 0 as it is. Rest all values will be the same. Now you got R2. You have to solve it. So when you solve it manually, when you write it, then only it is very clear. So I request all of you to take the pen and paper, write down and try to solve. Okay? So now you have to construct R3. To construct R3, circle third row and third column. So circle your third row and third column. So once you have circled the third row and third column, so what I told, you write down that values in this matrix as it is. So third row, third column, same value you are going to get. So once you have circled this third row, third column, now write down the values what is there in the circled row and column. After that, in which all position 1 is there, you copy that as it is. Right? So then you are going to check this 0 here. You are going to check this 0. Right? So here 0 is there. Right? So here 0, here 0. So in this R3 you will get 0. 1 already 1. No need to check wherever 1 is there. Only wherever 0 is there. Now here 0, here 0. So here also you will get 0. Here 0, 0. So this place also will be as it is 0. Now here all 1 is there, so no need to check if you have got 1. So now R3 you have constructed. Now you have to construct the last matrix R4. So what you have to do? Circle fourth row, fourth column, and write down the values of that circled row and column as it is, and wherever 1 is there write down as it is, and wherever 0 is there now you are going to check. Right? Now you start with this 0. Now see here 1. Here also 1, both place 1 is there. Now replace this 0 with 1 in your next point. Here 1 already it is there. Now this 0. 1 and 1. So here 1 you are going to get. Next this 1. Here 1 is there. Right? Here 1 is there. Corresponding row 0. So 0. What about this? 1 and 0. So 0 only. So 1 and 0. 0. Right? So now this is your final transitive closure of our given graph. Okay? So this was the one method. Now what we have used? Warshall's algorithm in order to find the transitive closure of our given graph. Okay? So next section, now you are going to look into the Floyd's algorithm. Right? So now you try to solve this the example in our Warshall's program. So in the next section we are going to look into our Floyd's algorithm. So now Floyd's algorithm is also similar to our Warshall's algorithm, but here we are going to have a weighted graph. So why we need weighted graph? Because we want to find the all pair shortest path problem. So Floyd's algorithm is also termed as all pair shortest path problem. Okay, so we will be discussing those in our next class. So if you have tried to solve this Warshall's algorithm, so we have solved two examples. Similarly, you take some examples from your the previous year question paper and try to solve it. So if you have any doubt, you can just drop a query in our classroom. Practice the problem. Okay. Thanks for watching this. Take care. Bye bye.